Hello for Thursday, September 10th. Well, as you know, stock charts we use here on this video and also on the site, they were down for like, I don't know, 8 hours or something. Really, I think they need a backup internet service provider. Evidently, they only have one, which seems very strange for a large site, but anyway, they do. So that's why we're late. We didn't want to use our other charts. So first off, we have on the Dow, you know, interesting thing. We put out a tweet on this, and I think we also posted in the chat room. Here we see the Dow. This is the 15-minute chart, and you can see we ran up to this high. This high on the chart that we posted during the day on Wednesday is when it ran right up to resistance 2. The stock had gone down to support 1 underneath the pivot, bounced there, ran up past the pivot, past then support or resistance 1, then right up to resistance 2. That's when we posted that exactly at the high right here. That was a great time to short. Why? Because if it broke over, what are you going to risk? Maybe 5 points. And then you realize it's broken over cleanly, so cover your short. But it didn't do it. It ran over maybe a point and then came right back down. So this was a good trade, and it came right to support, as you can see here, and that's a good place to cover. So that worked out very well for whatever that was, about 70 points, something like that. So those are trades you look for, because the pivots do work. Now we have a trend line to watch. So if it breaks back below this trend line, that could be a shorting opportunity as well. And of course, above the high of the day, which was at 9577, that's an area to watch. Next up, we have got we've got the Russell. Now, this is the 5-minute chart in the Russell. Just wanted to show that it's been in this parallel channel for a couple of days. Here was the 8th. Actually, the lower line's been in there for a little longer than that, but here we've got the starting of the 8th, and then here is the 9th. And as you can see, so these are areas to watch. Now, it did break below its 50 period on the 5-minute chart, but it came down to the trend line. That's where it held. So once again, if it goes there, now, the second time, it might have higher risk of breaking to the downside, but those are places to go long because, once again, you can keep stops tight. Now, if it breaks through here, again, then we're looking at the 582 for possible support as well. If it breaks through there, then we're liable to go down to the 577. So that'd be a short between 582 and 577, at least one to watch for. Because, once again, if you shorted 582, if it goes back above it, then you can cover with minimal losses. If we get onto the Standard & Poor's 500, they're not in the order I thought they were. So now we've got the Toronto Stock Exchange, and you can see it pulled back almost to its 50-period EMA. This is the 60-minute chart, the one we've been showing. It was able to break to a new high, and then it pulled back down once again. So we'll just see what's going on with there. What will happen during the day? You know, we are getting close. Let me just see. I don't know why we don't, what happened to our S&P charts, but they're not up at the moment. Okay, so they're about the same as the Dow, as you know. On Wednesday, we had, again, about 7 new breakouts. That's about the same as the day before. So a lot of activity in the markets. Now, remember, we're getting close to these Bradley model turn date, as well as some other astrological changes that we talked about in the newsletter, somewhere between the 10th and the 14th or 15th perhaps. So watch for some change in the market direction. But of some of the breakouts that we had were like GRA. As you can see, they weren't huge moves, but they're pretty clean. And this was, that you'll see in a moment, across the board, tons and tons of them that took place. Now, ROC, this hit both the lower buy point and the second buy point up and closed up about 6%. So ROC was a good one for the day. GY was another one that hit a buy point, went up about 5.5% for the day. Then we have TIE, yet another one that hit that buy point and then moved up, and it also closed up about 5% for the day. So we had a lot of those. HX or XCO, another one that moved, not a big gainer as you can see, but broke above the 15 and closed up a bit. This could be a continuation. We've got a bunch more of those that we're going to show you. Other ones that we just talked about and didn't put on the watch list, but we showed in the charts on the day before, like ESLR, this is one that we've had in the chat room on Wednesday. I think someone pointed it to our attention below this line. So we said we'd buy over this line. and it went, and with the target being probably first the 50 day, and that's exactly where it hit on Wednesday. So this came out on Tuesday and we showed it, and then it ran up. Another one I think was also one that we, no. This one we may have shown, may not have shown, but we're looking at it. Moved above this first area. This one I guess we showed yesterday and said one to watch, but it hasn't, it's got a double area to buy. So you, some may have bought it. We'll put it on the list above 1675, this top line here. We'd like to see a return of better volume. So if it consolidates for a day or two, that'd be a better situation. Now some of the bigger movers will add, and but we'd like to see some consolidation first. This may have been short covering. The volume wasn't great, but a lot of times when the stock breaks below its 50-day and then has this kind of basing pattern, that isn't good for ones if they're in a downtrend. So probably there are a lot of shorts in here, and that could have been the reason. Maybe there was news you can check on, and it's up 12%, but if it consolidates sideways for a while and then can break over the 450 or the 460, this may be a trade at least for the day. So COMS added to the list. So it's C or JDAS. This also, there are lots, so many of these, it's bizarre. There were just so many on Wednesday. This up 13%. JDAS, if it can get above that 22.45, particularly if it can go sideways a few days first, this may make for a nice trade. CRZO above 22.75. This we've got a little time on, perhaps, but again, look at this huge volume. Just, there are just so many. Anyway, this is another one, CRZO we're looking at. How about HAFC over $1.90? Look familiar pattern? Increased volume, not as high as a few days back, but it sure did move up. So if we can break above this 190, let's just check its high was actually, yeah, its high was 189. So above 190. This may move as well. And MIC, a little bit different than the other charts. This one we've watched for a few days as well. So if this can get above its high of 715, but we want to see a little bigger increase in volume here on that one. Okay, I think we've got a couple others we just want to talk about or show. This one we didn't put on the list, but again, high volume, huge move up, and then it lost a lot of those moves. So this may be one that could be a trade in this area between the 163 and 173 for people who like to play lower price stocks in that area. Then we'll see. We've got some other ones we want to mention here. There's a lot of them, so let me just see where we want to start. I think we're going to start maybe with Hero, and we'll just buzz through these real quickly. These could be continuation plays. There's just too many. We didn't put them on the list, but there's a lot of them. So we got HERO, as you can see. These are all very similar patterns. You've got JNMBA, a lower price stock as well, as you can see, 125 here, 125 over here. Big volume move on that one as well. Also, we've got SYNA. We had our user here in the chat room mention this before it got to this line. We thought, yes, if it can break above the 27.62, probably could be a buy. And that's what it was. 27.62 ran to 27.99. So that was on its way possible to the moving averages. You can see when they touch each other, a lot of times there's violent movements, and that's exactly what happened here. How about CPX is yet another one that moved above what could have been a buy point here. So if we had these on the list, they would have just kind of triggered, as you can see. But again, higher volume, another one moved up like that. How about EBS? Yet again, another one, same situation. I've never seen a day when there's so many that have almost identical charts like this, and that's the way it was. It's like, does that mean the top is near? Well, I don't know. Could be. TPX is yet another one, similar situation. This goes on and on and on and on. I don't think I can show them all. So let's just stop there. So anyway, I hope you have a good Thursday. I'll get the, now the charts are working again, so I'll find some more again for tomorrow as well. So have a great trading day. Thanks a lot for coming by the site, seeing the chat room, and we'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas. Bye-bye.